Reminiscence is a brand new sci-fi crime thriller that was released simultaneously in theaters and on HBO Max this past weekend. It's directed by Lisa Joy. Lisa Joy is one of the screenwriters and producers for Westworld, and she wrote and produced and directed this film. And she's also married to Jonathan Nolan, who is Christopher Nolan's brother. The film stars Hugh Jackman and Rebecca Ferguson and Cliff Curtis and Thandie Newton, among other people, some talented people. Sonny from Into the Badlands shows up in this movie. So the plot here takes place sometime in the future. It's kind of a post-apocalyptic type of scenario that is set up in this movie. In this future, people are really disillusioned with their present and with their future, so they would like to go back and look at their past instead. There's a special kind of technology that has been created that allows people to relive their memories, and not just relive them like watch them on a teleprompter or something like that, but relive them like actually live through these memories and experience them firsthand again. Hugh Jackman and Thandie Newton possess this technology and they use it for their business. And to make a long story short, Hugh Jackman's character eventually meets Rebecca Ferguson's character. They fall in love. Then all of a sudden, Rebecca Ferguson's character disappears, like she vanishes into thin air. So Hugh Jackman now has to try to use this technology to find out where she may have gone. The more he looks for her, the more he stumbles onto some mysterious conspiracy that turns out to be way more than he or his friend Thandie Newton bargained for. Speaking of the title Reminiscence, this movie is definitely gonna help you, no pun intended. This movie's definitely gonna make you reminisce about some of the other sci-fi movies that you've seen over the years, because this movie definitely takes inspiration from a lot of different ones. At times you're gonna see some elements of Inception, you might see some elements of Total Recall or something like that. There's a neo-noir kind of feel to this film and its storytelling that will definitely remind people of Blade Runner. Some people are gonna criticize that about the movie and they're gonna say, well, okay, that means the movie's copying or it's unoriginal or whatever. And I sort of see where they're coming from, but to me it's really more like paying homage and, like I said, taking inspiration. That's what it felt like when you're watching the movie. Nothing really I can say about Hugh Jackman that hasn't already been said. You know who Hugh Jackman is. You know what he brings to a movie. You know how great he is. He's one of the best actors of this generation. In fact, if I came to you outright in the review and I said, actually, Hugh Jackman was not that good in this movie, he was actually pretty bad, you'd be like,
what? Blasphemy. No way. I have to go see the movie now.
You know what? Maybe I should have come out with this review like a day ago, and maybe I should have come out and told you that Hugh Jackman is not good in the movie, because then maybe more of you would have gone to see this movie. Just saying, the movie has like a $68 million budget and apparently it made like $2 million at the box office this weekend, so fuck. The other two co-leads of the movie, Rebecca Ferguson and Thandie Newton. Thandie Newton plays one of his best friends in this movie. Rebecca Ferguson obviously is his love interest, so their chemistry is going to really decide whether or not you're invested in that element of the story. There is kind of an interesting world that was sort of set up in this movie. I mean, I do wish it was fleshed out a little bit more, but you can't deny the outline, the general blueprint for the world is there. And it makes me feel like maybe this would have been better served being explored in a series or something like that. As far as everything else with the movie, it is definitely competently shot. In fact, there's some beautiful shots, including some beautiful underwater shots that looks like they use natural lighting for some of these moments. There's not that much action in the movie, but when the action is there, it's actually pretty good. There's a really exciting action sequence later on in the film that reminds me of like people fighting on a sinking ship. And that was kind of a really cool element of the movie that I wanted to throw out there. The idea of people not being happy with their present, so they look for answers in the past, they look for comfort in the past. That whole nostalgia is the most powerful drug known to man. That element is present here. And again, it's not necessarily an original idea, but it is an interesting one. You've heard this from my reviews before, you've heard this from other reviews. Sometimes there's a world of difference between potential and reality. There's a world of difference between a great idea on paper and the execution of it when it comes across on screen. This movie was actually kind of a mess, if I'm being honest. It starts for me with the over-reliance on the exposition in this film. I know a lot of movies have some exposition. They're kind of hard to avoid in your script when you're making a movie like this. But a lot of it feels very heavy-handed and a lot of it feels unnecessary. And this, unfortunately, is made worse by this long, droning, monotonous voiceover narration that Hugh Jackman's character is doing for majority of the runtime. It really doesn't add anything to the movie, to the character, to anything. A lot of it feels very unnecessary. Some of it feels like they could have just let some of the visuals and some of the world building speak for itself. I also think this film gets a little bit too convoluted for its own good as the movie goes on into the second and third acts. There is a lot of information that is being thrown around, that is being tossed at the screen. screen. Some of it feels very unnecessary when you step back and look at the story as a whole and how all of these connective threads weave together. It's kind of like, did you guys really need to overcomplicate things by the time you get to the end? I would say the biggest problem for the film is that they just struggled to engage me as a viewer with the story that they were telling. Like, really the only thing I cared about in the movie was Hugh Jackman and Rebecca Ferguson and their relationship. The other subplots, the other narrative threads, the other convoluted means of the story, you know, and some of the villain characters, their motivations, they just failed to really engage and make that interesting or compelling to me as a viewer. It just made the movie not as much fun to watch. I don't think it's nearly as bad as what some other people are saying. I thought that it was interesting at times, it was well done at times, but at times it's kind of a half and half type of thing, because at times the movie was actually kind of boring to watch. Reminiscence was okay. It could have been better, it could have been worse. I'm gonna leave this one in the Fortress of Solitude. I'm not gonna ask you if you've seen it, because odds are you haven't. Let's just be honest here. Tell me what your favorite sci-fi property of the last 5 to 10 years is. Put that in the comment section down below. Like and subscribe to the Superfan Show, and if you like what you see, tell me how you feel, and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Peace.